All right, so today we're going to talk about the Health Services Platforms Consortium, so the healthcare innovation ecosystem. My name is Nikolai Schwertner. I used to be the lead developer of smart platforms and also the CEO of MedUpTech, which was a company which focused on developing smart applications and solutions. So we developed the growth charts, blood pressure percentiles applications, Duke Pillbox, the first version of the smart apps gallery, and many others. And I'm currently co-founder, chief innovation officer of Interopian, which is the successor of MedUpTech. And we have expanded our activities, so now we don't just do applications, we also do platforms and integrations and consulting and others. And we also are the development wing of the HSPC consortium. Okay, so in this session, I'd like to give you an understanding of HSPC. How many of you are not yet familiar with HSPC and the HSPC sandbox? Okay, that's good. And how many of you are of technical background, so developers? Okay, fantastic. So this is a great mix right here. So I think this presentation is for you folks. So I'd like to also give you hands-on experience with the HSPC sandbox, which is based on Smart on Fire, and it's cloud-hosted and completely free. Also, I'll give you a preview of our upcoming release of the HSPC sandbox, and also walk you over some development resources that we've got. So hopefully, I'll give you some things which you'll find useful in your app development endeavors. Okay, so the HSPC is a consortium, like I mentioned. It was formed by the Veterans Administration, Intermountain Healthcare, Louisiana State University, and some of the other members include Vigilance, Motif, Registry, AllScript, Cerner, Osera, PCPI, and JCS, and the list is growing. So the vision of the HSPC consortium is to be a provider-led organization which accelerates the delivery of innovative health applications and therefore improves healthcare. So the HSPC does many things. We have committees which build profiles, evaluate open specifications, develop guides about how to apply those specifications. But one of the key things that HSPC does is we've put out there a developers program for people like you who'd like to get started with developing applications using FHIR, using Smart on FHIR, and kicking the tires on the standards. So you guys build the applications, and we've got the right tools for you. So some of the tools that HSPC offers is a developer portal, which is a collection of resources which are relevant to developers who use these standards, a sandbox environment, which essentially is a reference implementation, free to all, and ready to be used. I'll show you that hands-on in just a moment. And a gallery where you can publish and share your applications. And some of the other things that we offer are SDKs and libraries, particularly for Smart on FHIR, in a couple different popular platforms, samples and tutorials, and documentation as well. Okay, so let's talk about the HSPC sandbox. So the sandbox, it's a fully functional Smart on FHIR sandbox, so it's built upon, it comes with a FHIR server, with data manager, app launcher, authorization service, all the different components that you need to orchestrate and get working together so that you can have an environment in which you can run your applications in a secure mode against FHIR data. It is vendor neutral environment, which offers reference level implementation of FHIR. And it's a great starting point to develop applications and test them. It's easy to get started in the sandbox if you want to work with some of the vendor, Sandbox, etc., there is a registration process. Each one is ever so different, and there are some differences in the implementation, some idiosyncrasies, which you will need to deal with eventually once you get to the point where you're ready to publish your application and put it out there. But just to get started, you don't need to deal with those things in the very beginning. So the Sandbox is great for that. And just want to underscore that a Sandbox environment is only meant to be used with non-PHI data folks. So no support for HIPAA whatsoever, very limited support, and no SLA, no uptime guarantees. Although we have been pretty good at keeping, you know, having good availability of the Sandbox and keeping it pretty robust, but just keep those things in mind. It's not meant for production. It's meant to be a playground type environment. And for those of you who enjoy architecture diagrams, this is a diagram which kind of shows you some of the aspects of the HSPC Sandbox. So inside, we are housing a number of sandboxes, so you can build your own sandboxes. Each sandbox that you create, you have inside users, personas, launch scenarios, a FHIR resource, server, all the things, all the good things that you need. So we create those for you. And Happy FHIR, for those of you who are curious, is the FHIR resource server, which is used by the HSPC platform. And then we expose a number of tools which you can use to manage your sandbox and change its state and run your application. We have an authorization server, which happens to be MITRE ID Connect, which is a real OAuth server profiled to Smart, so you actually experience the real authentication sequences. There is a terminology server also in there, and you can use it to query popular terminology such as NOMAD and WOINC and resolve codes. And you can run all of your applications in this environment. Okay, so to get to a common ground, I want to offer a couple quick definitions here of a couple things you encounter in the HSPC Sandbox. The Sandbox user, so that's an actor, that's a person who has an account on HSPC, has access to the Sandbox environment, is able to create sandboxes, share sandboxes, participate in the environment. A persona, on the other hand, in the HSPC Sandbox environment, that's a model user, that's not a real user. That's a model user, and we model a practitioner or a patient, and you can assign this user when you're launching an application, and you can basically feed the user to the application. So if the application is introspecting who the user is who launched the application, you can tell it, oh, it's this practitioner or this patient, and you can direct the context in which the application has been launched. So persona is a virtual user inside the sandbox. Sandbox user is the real user. And the launch scenario, that's essentially a preset context in which you can launch your application and do that over and over again as you're testing. So you can control the environment in which your application is running for testing purposes. Okay, so without further delay, let's jump into the HSPC Sandbox, and I want to give you a hands-on demonstration. Okay, so to find the HSPC Sandbox, I recommend visiting the HSPC Consortium. That's interesting. Okay. Let's end the slideshow and, all right, there we go, better. Okay, so a good launching point for your exploration of the HSPC services and the Sandbox is hspcconsortium.org. And when you visit the HSPC Consortium website, the way to find the Sandbox is it's under the Developers menu. And if you click on Sandbox, that will take you straight to the HSPC Sandbox environment. Okay, and first thing you get is the login screen where you can, and of course, if you don't have an account already, you need to sign up for an account. I just so happen to have already signed up. You can authenticate using your Google account, which I already apparently have authenticated, so it didn't ask me to authenticate, or you can set up a new account. when you first set up your account, you actually be automatically subscribed to this sandbox, HSPC Cynthia. It's a sandbox which has a collection of roughly 1,000 sample patients, which are based on the Massachusetts Cynthia project, which are modeled on the typical patient profile in Massachusetts and have been synthetically generated. So that's a great set if you want to build population applications and try to identify patients with certain conditions, et cetera. And we give that to you. So that will be the sandbox which you will start with. And I have actually already created a second sandbox for testing purposes. Let's go ahead and create a sandbox now so that you guys, you folks see what how that works. All right, so you need to pick a sandbox name, so FHIR DevDays. I'll call the sandbox like that. Then the version of FHIR that you'd like to work with. We currently offer DSTU2, STU3. I'll stay with STU3. And the new version, which will be rolling out very soon, will also support R4 for those of you who want to stay ahead of the curve. Allow open FHIR endpoint will essentially allow an endpoint which is not authenticated, so no OAuth protection. If you'd like to test just raw FHIR, no OAuth, no smart, you can do that as well. And apply the default data set that's going to import the default smart set of sample patients that you can use for test your application. So let's go ahead and create the sandbox. It's only going to take a moment. Okay, there we go. That wasn't that long. Okay, so first screen which you're going to encounter is a collection of sample applications which we already imported for you and you can play with, but I'm not going to go over details of those because in the next version they're actually going to change soon enough. So under patients is where you can see the list and you can search through the list of sample patients in your sandbox. The default data set for SMART is 68 patients. You can also start with an empty sandbox and import your own patients if you like. You get one sample practitioner to get started, or you can create your own practitioners, etc. So let's take a look at what are the steps to register your applications in the HSPC sandbox so that you can test your applications. I'll assume that you folks have a basic at least familiarity with FHIR and with SMART. So for this demonstration, what I'd like to use is the SMART on FHIR sample patients. So if you go to this GitHub page, github.com/smartonfhir, one of the repositories, sample apps stu3, this is the repository which I'm going to use. So it contains a number of sample applications for SMART. HSPC gives you some other applications. I'd like to use those particularly because I wrote a number of those applications, so I'm quite familiar with them. So let's go ahead and grab this repository. It's a GitHub repository, so I'm going to fetch the URL of the repository, and then I need to spin up my GitHub client. In this case, I'm going to use my command line GitHub client. This is readable, let's make it bigger. And we'll use the git clone command to fetch the repository. Okay, so now I've got the sample applications sitting on my desktop. And inside there is a collection of different sample applications. The one which I'd like to use as a hello world of SMART is the medications application. So it's a very, very simple application which essentially prints the medications of a patient. Let's also load it into an IDE so that we can actually see the code a little bit better. In this case, I'll use Microsoft Visual Studio Code free IDE available out there. There's a number of others you guys can use. And here is the medications application. It's extremely simple. It's the whole world of the smart applications. It has a launcher and then has the main application code, which then collects queries the FHIR server for the patient's medications and then prints them out on the screen. Okay, what we need for this application is to get the FHIR JavaScript client. And if you read the README here, which I have, what you need to do is run npmi after you install Node.js. Or you can do it manually if you like, but the script here will help you do it using Node. And that fetches the FHIR client. Also, this command also downloads an HTTP server, which we can use to actually host this application on localhost and try it out. I'm going to get that started with npm start. It's all in the README for the application. And now I have an HTTP server which serves the application on port 9090 on localhost. So I'm going to remember this URL right here. And now let's switch back to the HSPC sandbox. And in the sandbox environment, let's create a new application. So I'm going to click on register manually. Okay, so we'll call this the medications application. The launch URL, that's the base URL of the application, and we'll append launch.html. Doesn't have to be launch.html, but for this particular sample apps, the launch URL is the launch.html, and then the redirect URL is the base URL of the application. So it's a patient's code application. It's a public client. You can also set it to confidential, but I know that this application requires a public client. And if you're a visual person, you may also want to kind of upload an image for the application so that it looks a little bit better in your sandbox. Okay, so now my application is, my new shiny application is registered in the sandbox. I get an important message here, which is the client ID, which has been assigned to the application by my OAuth server. I'll need this thing, so I'm going to copy it, because my application needs to be aware of this client ID. So for these sample apps, the place to drop the client ID is right here inside launch.html. So there we go. I dropped the ID. And also, take a note of the scope with the application requires. This application requires patient star.read, so we're going to read all the resources available for the patient in scope. And that's important, which scope the application requires. We'll need to configure inside the HSPC sandbox the right scope so that the sandbox will grant this scope when the application actually requests it. So I'm going to change the scope of the application to patient star.read, and I also need the launch scope, which is for patient scoped applications. And while we're at it, we may also add a little description for the application. Okay, there we go. Now, if everything went well, I should be able to launch my application. So we'll click on the launch button, and then we get a selection of patients. I'll pick the first patient right here, Daniel Adams. And this is a good sign. So we're at the authorization stage of a typical smart on FHIR application. That's the OAuth server asking us to grant permissions to the application and telling us what the application is asking for. So I'm going to authorize the application on just one-time basis. And then the application now fetches the data from FHIR using the token obtained from the OAuth server and gets the medications of the patient inside the HSPC sandbox. Okay, so that was good. Just to give you a very quick example of another class of applications, which is interesting, The sample apps, okay. So this is a patient-scoped application. There is a number of other smart applications. There are standalone smart applications. There are population background service applications. So I also want to show you this sample application called Population. It's a population-level application. I'm going to very quickly fetch the dependencies and spin it up. But before I do that, I actually want to make sure that when it's hosted, it actually does not try to walk onto port 1990 because I'm already using that with my other application. So I'm going to change the port to 8000 here in the package.json. And I think now we should be ready to launch it, npm start. Okay, there we go. So now we have the second application running on port 8000. And let's now go ahead and create this application real quick. So that's my population application. So the launch URL is, okay, this, and the redirect, just the same I did before, nothing different. And let's assign this image to it. Okay, there we go. And just again, we fetch the client ID, we drop it in the application, in the launcher. There we go. And notice, this application actually is a user-level application. So it does not launch in the context of a particular patient. It actually is going to ask for access to all the patients which are accessible to this particular user. So let's change the scope accordingly. So that's user star dot star, and this application is going to find all users with active medications. Okay. I think we're ready to give it a try. So launch the application. In this case, this is what I wanted to show you. Since the application is not going to launch in the context of any particular patient, what you want to do is not select a patient. What you want to do is continue without a patient, actually. That's why we have this option here at the bottom. So I'm going to continue without a patient. I'm going to authorize the application. And let's see if that works. Okay, there we go. So it's going and fetching some patients from the sandbox. And this application would take a little bit longer than the previous application because it's iterating over all the patients that I've got in this particular sandbox. It's not the most efficient way to fetch a population of patients, but it works and it's portable across vendors who support user-level scopes. If you want something a little bit more efficient, then you might want to look into FHIR, flat FHIR, or bulk data FHIR. That offers a more efficient way to transmit large amounts of data. Okay, so we're almost done. And there we go. This application is now displaying the patients with active medications and sorted by the number of active medications. Something semi-useful for demonstration purposes. Okay, so what else can we do in the HSPC sandbox? We've got an EHR simulator, so it gives you a quick way to preview how your application might look inside a typical EHR in embedded mode. So it does exactly what the name says. It's an EHR simulator. So it will ask you to set the context, just like you would in an EHR. So now my EHR is primed to provider John Smith and patient Daniel Adams, and then here are the applications which I registered, and I can tap between them and see them into embedded mode. So for example, I'm going to launch the medications application, and it will be launched inside this browser iframe here in the context of our mock EHR. So we can play around with that as well. We can explore the sample patients. We can search through the sample patients. we actually can click on a sample patient, and this is going to give us some useful information about the patient. It's going to tell us the number of resources which are associated with that patient, so we can judge whether that's an interesting patient or not that such an interesting patient. It's going to reveal the smart, the FHIR identifier of the patient. And we also have a patient data manager tool which allows us to play around with the, it's actually a smart application end of itself, so it goes through the same authentication sequence which we are offering out there, and it actually allows us to mess around with the patient at will. So for example, we can look at the medication requests, so we can click on one and then we can edit it, or we can create a new medication request, etc. We can copy, and essentially we have quite a bit of freedom to edit some of the standard resources which one would expect, particularly US core and a couple other resources of the patient. And we can create new patients as well. Same thing with practitioners, which are FHIR resources actually in and of themselves. We can create practitioners. Personas, if you remember, in my definition slide, a persona is a virtual user inside our sandbox, inside our Moki HR environment. And the persona can be a patient, can be a practitioner, can be other class of users, of course, but right now we support patient and practitioner. We've already created a default persona for you, but if you'd like, you can create additional personas. So in case you're testing an application which is aware about the user who has launched it. Data manager is a place which is a section of the sandbox which you can use to play around with the data. Inside the sandbox, essentially, you can construct any FHIR query and run it against the underlying HAPI server. We have a couple examples to get you started. And this particular FHIR query comes back with a set of three patients, and we can actually see the raw FHIR serialized in JSON, which is the result of our request. We can export also data out of our server in FHIR format. For example, let's try exporting patient Daniel Adams. I'll grab the patient's FHIR ID, and then in data manager we'll say export. I just don't want to export the whole set of data. If I click export all, I'll get the whole, all the sample patients, all the resource, everything. But in this case, I actually want just the patient with ID, this ID here. And then let's run this. Okay, that looks good. I just got a bundle which contains the patient resource of Daniel Adams, and I can save it locally, and then I can load it into my IDE, and then look at this beautiful FHIR as an example, and then maybe do something cool with it. And then when I'm done editing this FHIR, I can maybe import it into a new sandbox or in the same sandbox using the import tool right here. User management is if you want to delegate access to your sandbox to fellow developers and collaborate on your sandbox. That's the place to do it. For example, I'm going to invite my other alter ego here and send that invitation. And that's going to send your collaborator an email. They need to confirm, and then they'll gain access to the sandbox, and you'll be able to collaborate on it. EHR integration gives you a set of references and resources which are useful if you'd like to integrate with EHR vendors who support FHIR and Smart. We have some documentation about the sandbox which should help answer a lot of the questions which you might have. There's also a user support forum which I recommend visiting if you're looking for an answer or connecting with other developers. That's always a useful place to go to. And finally, settings is where you can control your particular sandbox. You can change the name of the sandbox. You can reset your sandbox in case you want to get rid of the default data patients and just start with a blank sandbox, or import the default patients reversely, or delete the sandbox, any of those actions. And you can switch between sandboxes right here in the top right, top left corner. Okay, so what else do we have? Here there is a reference to the HSPC gallery. This is the place. Interesting. Okay, maybe I didn't click right. So the HSPC gallery is a place where you can discover other smart applications, and you can also publish your own application. So it's kind of like the smart app gallery. Similar. For example, we can take a look at this growth chart application, which you might have already seen, and we can actually try it out inside the HSPC environment to see what it does. And we can learn by example in this way. And the developers portal, which is available right here, is a really good website, which we hope will help you in your smart applications development endeavors. And that contains a number of tutorials, sample applications, resources to get you started, libraries for smart JavaScript based on JavaScript, Java, and Swift client. The Java client is the one which HSPC actually developed and supports. The others are provided by Smart. You can learn more about profiling, FHIR, etc. Okay. So finally, I want to show you very quick the integration that. All right. Sorry about that. Inside your sandbox, there is going to be this special application, CDS hook sandbox. So for those of you who are playing with the CDS hook standard, this is the link between the HSPC sandbox and the CDS hooks harness. So from this application, you can actually set a context for the CDS hooks harness. I'm going to launch with Daniel Adams. And that's actually going to load the CDS hooks harness with this particular patient, and then we can try CDS hook services out there. For example, we can try to prescribe Zofran to this patient, which actually will invoke a CDS hook service, which advises us that, well, basically the cost of this medication is off the roof as a brand application, but as a branded medication, but there is a generic which is going to save us a ton of money and probably not the most favorite one of big pharma, but that's an example CDS hooks application out there. And I want to give you a preview of, just like I promised, we'll give you a preview of the next generation HSPC sandbox, which we'll be rolling out very soon. So it's very, very similar to the current sandbox platform, but has some neat improvements, some subtle improvements, some not so subtle improvements, and certainly a lot of UI improvements. So if you were in the current sandbox, you should feel right at home with the new one once it is available. A lot of the paradigms are similar. But it also contains some improvements and fresh features out here, and hopefully will be more friendly to use than the existing sandbox environment out there. Oh, this is the invitation which I just sent to myself for the test sandboxes out there. Okay. All right. So to wrap up the presentation. So now you folks are familiar with the HSPC sandbox. It's a free resource. We'd like to invite you to use it to build wonderful health applications and spread the word about your work of hard labor, which is empowered by the new generation standards and tools out there. The HSPC Sandbox is currently used by 1,430 users. We have 834 unique sandboxes. This is very fresh data just from today. And in the last 30 days, we had 148 new users. So the user base here is growing quite rapidly. The links, if you'd like to copy them down to the HSPC resources, hspcconsortium.org is the main website, and from there you will find links to the developers portal and to the Sandbox platform and other HSPC consortium resources and tools. Okay, so we're just coming to the hour, and we have a few more minutes left, so I'd like to open the stage for questions in case anybody has any question. Also, here is my email address in case you'd like to contact me. Okay, all right. Anybody would like to ask a question about HSPC or the Sandbox? Oh, thanks, Isaac.
This already, Nikolai. I apologize.
All right. Okay, thank you. Great question. So each sandbox essentially runs in, it's a happy instance, has its own database schema in MySQL, and it's isolated from the other sandboxes. And then we support the latest version of happy, which supports DSTU2 and STU3 and R4. Actually, the new version of the HSPC sandbox supports R4. And you can choose which one you'd like. The only catch is that over time, as HAPI evolves, they change their database schema, and sometimes they're able to import the previous schema and upgrade it. Sometimes they're not able to, so some really old schemas are not easy to upgrade, and we don't have the resources to be upgrading those. So if you've created your sandbox a while back, eventually it may be dropped, actually. So that's the downside of sandbox environments, but it's a singular DBMS, but there are 834 schemas in there, individual, on the same database server, basically. The whole infrastructure runs on Amazon Web Services in the cloud, and it's scalable, so it will scale up as resources are needed. So there is a load balancer and all of these things.
Mm-hmm. How is the transition? I'm pretty sure you get ways to do that, but how has it been the experience of people that have done it, I guess?
Okay, thank you for this question. So once you get your application running and successfully launching against the HSPC sandbox and the sample patients, you're in pretty good shape. In my experience, the next step now testing your applications with Epic's sandbox, Cerner sandbox, etc., you're in good shape. You know that your application is going to launch, is going to authenticate just fine. There are some differences, and what I found is with each vendor there's ever so slight difference. For example, one vendor might support star scoped, so wildcard scopes, so patient/star.read. Other vendors might insist that you need to specify the type of resource, so you may need to tweak your scopes. Then the FHIR queries, which your application runs, the query formats may be slightly different. Still FHIR, it's still standards-based, but there might be limitations in the length of the string. Some may insist, for example, on using a particular subset of queries. For example, I think one vendor requires that when you ask for observations of a patient, you don't just ask for all the observations, you specify, I want the observations with these particular one codes, et cetera. So you need to deal with these little differences and you learn them as you try to work your way with the different vendor environments. And also the FHIR that you get back might be a little bit different. So maybe the US core resources will be fairly uniform across the vendors to a large extent, but once you venture outside of US core, you start encountering differences in the way things are coded and expressed. And FHIR is very open and flexible, so it does leave room for interpretation until profiles are agreed upon and enforced. Hope that answers. Okay. Oh, fantastic question. Well, currently there is no limit. Well, the limit is how much our system can handle, really. So I hope nobody abuses that. But actually, so the HSPC is currently funded by Veterans Administration and Intermountain and such. But we'd like to extend the services, but that, of course, requires resources. So there is now some talk at the HSPC that, okay, so we offer the free services, but we may, in addition to them, offer some paid tiers of services which offer even more resources and support and SLA and so forth and so on. So that's still early stage, this talk, but that's probably a way moving forward. Of course, HSPC is an open organization. We hope that other organizations join the consortium and contribute to this platform. But to answer your question right now, there is no hard limit on to how many sandboxes you can create. Okay, fantastic. I think we're out of time. I don't want to hold you back from your nights out, so thank you very much.